have Dr. Akriti Gupta along with us, who's a consultant gynecologist and an IVF specialist. I welcome you all to this live session where we'll be talking about infertility issues in PCOS. So as you all know that infertility is a very common concern in women with PCOS, right? So Dr. Akriti, please highlight on the importance of, you know, why should we know about this thing, the infertility issue? Why is it important to know about this?
Hi Divya, thanks for welcoming me again. And last time we talked about PCOS or PCOD, polycystic ovarian syndrome, and we just touched upon the symptoms and diagnosis. So we thought that we'll just have a word on why it is important for us to know that infertility is also an issue because of which PCOS is a concern. So you see that I already stressed upon last time that there is very much role of, the pathophysiology or the causes of PCOS, which are affected by our environmental factors, whether that's our lifestyle or, you know, our diet or physical activity or the stress, the environmental stress. So all these, they lead to a kind of a chronic inflammation in the body, and certain, you know, mechanisms are there which increase some amount of chemicals which are unhealthy, you can say. So these are unhealthy for the body. So what they lead to is they lead to infertility also. So if we start following this lifestyle, you know, from the start in adolescence only, or when the girl marries or is about to get married, so she should be aware that if she has this constant lifestyle, she'll be, you know, cutting this infertility issue or the fertility issues, you can say in general, that will be less faced by her. Okay, so this is just a prevention precaution which we want to tell the ladies out there, that you must, you know, keep a watch on your health and your diet or even your lifestyle, which you can say, so that you go ahead and have a healthy, fertile life. So that's why it's important to talk about it.
But I think it's very important because, you know, women with PCOS feel if they're not planning to get pregnant, they should not care about their PCOS. But that should not be like this, right?
Yeah, they should.
ये फर्दर कॉम्प्लिकेशन हो सकती है आगे जाके, सो दे शुड बी अवेयर अबाउट दिस थिंग, राइट? यस. सो व्हाट इज द व्हाई इज इट इम्पोर्टेंट टू नो अबाउट दिस? आई हैव ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड, आई एम सॉरी. सो हाउ पीसीओएस लीड्स टू इनफर्टिलिटी, लाइक व्हाट इज द कॉज, एग्जैक्ट कॉज?
या एग्जैक्टली, लाइक वी डिस्कस लास्ट टाइम दैट इन द ओवरीज यू हैव यू नो मल्टीपल सिस्ट्स व्हिच गेट फॉर्मड, यू नो, एंड देयर इज अ पैथोलॉजी, देयर इज अ इंक्रीज नंबर ऑफ मेल हार्मोन्स इन योर बॉडी, इन द फीमेल बॉडी. So what exactly is there? It creates an androgenic environment, which leads to these small the follicles which are growing, which are the eggs basically, in a common language. They don't go to so much of extent to such a size that they are able to release. Okay, so that process is hampered. That is one reason. The other is that there is increased insulin resistance, and there is an imbalance of the hormones from the brain, which I told you last time as well, increased luteinized LH hormone, which also adds up to the increased amounts of male androgens in the body, and thereby having an effect in the ovary, which leads to again anovulation. So that is one aspect. Then it also affects the, you know, the uterus lining, which is important for the baby which is formed to get implanted. So there are certain chemicals in the body which are released, which are negative, have a negative influence on implantation because of that chronic inflammation process of PCOS. So that leads to failure of implantation, you can say, and there is high risk of miscarriage. So that is another way that it affects infertility also, as well as it can lead to miscarriage in, later on, once if she becomes pregnant. Thirdly, the quality of the egg which is formed in PCOS patients, because many patients, they will come to us that number of eggs are there in the ovaries, but then why is it that they are not getting pregnant? The number of eggs is good. Okay, so still she's not getting pregnant. So where is the ha? So the first reason is anovulation. She might not be properly releasing the egg. Or then there can be the quality will be affected. The quality itni achhi nahi hogi because of the that chronic environment of inflammation, and there will be so bad egg quality, which can lead to a bad embryo quality, baby ki quality kharab banegi, jiski wajah se implantation nahi hogi. So again there will be failure of, you know, baby to get implanted, and then again pregnancy nahi hogi. So that is the third. So there are multiple reasons which can, which in which way PCOS can affect your infertility. So we need to understand ki do teen levels pe aisa ho sakta hai.
Okay. And what are the ways to manage these issues? Like,
सी लाइक इट डिपेंड्स कि हमारे पास पेशेंट जो आते हैं लाइक इफ द लेडी शी इज प्लानिंग प्रेगनेंसी एंड शी नोज दैट हर पीरियड्स आर रेगुलर सपोज तो एक एक एग्जाम्पल हो गया कि पीरियड्स रेगुलर हैं तो इफ दे आर रेगुलर देन वी नीड टू नो कि वेदर शी इज ओव्यूलेटिंग और नॉट मतलब प्रॉपरली एग बड़ा साइज का बन रहा है मे बी हर पीरियड्स आर गेटिंग लिटिल डिलेड बाई 1 week और समथिंग तो इफ शी इज गेटिंग पीरियड्स बट लेट आ रहे हैं हफ्ता लेट हो गए हैं जैसे सपोज बट रेगुलर आ रहे हैं So then we need to see whether egg is forming or whether egg is not forming. What is the size of that egg? So for that we need to do few scans. जब उसका periods का cycle होता है, during that we keep, you know, doing scans. Maybe for example, 10th day पे, 12th day पे, like this. So we keep doing those. That is called follicular scans. So उसमें हम देखते हैं कि how it is growing. So as in if we see कि अच्छी तरह से grow कर रहा है, we ask her to try naturally. तो वो नेचुरली ट्राई कर सकते हैं बट सपोज इफ यू सी दैट दैट पेशेंट इज ओबीस उसी टाइम बट इफ अ पीरियड्स आर रेगुलर यू नो बट दैट इज अनलाइकली अगर वो शी इज फैट एंड शी इज यू नो हैविंग अ रेगुलर पीरियड दैट इज वेरी अनलाइकली बट सपोज अगर ऐसा भी है दैट शी इज फैट एंड शी इज स्टिल हैविंग हर यू नो साइकल्स रेगुलर देन वी स्टिल एडवाइज हर टू लूज हर वेट So okay. we've already talked about it last time
yes,
as well.
Right, right.
Agar
right.
we need to, you know, control on weight and that will right. help him her getting naturally pregnant
yes.
so that healthy is one way yes. healthy lifestyle has to be there so
yes.
then after that if suppose her you know we talked about regular periods first but suppose her you know periods are not regular and first we need to make it regular we need to have some pills that will help her making her cycles regular and then again see for the same process whether egg is forming what is the size of the egg how it is growing so that we can tell her that whether she can plan naturally or whether she will be needing some you know medicines that we can talk later but primarily if she is having lifestyle issues we will always advise her to go for a change in the lifestyle first have a healthy weight on and then come back because you know it will also increase her chances of pregnancy plus after she has lost weight she'll have a healthy pregnancy also so because there are other complications of being heavyweight in pregnancy so other than you know conceiving later on in pregnancy also she will have a complications because of that so for that
so
I think you can talk again
first right
so you can just elaborate again for them
okay so we've already talked about the diet and PCOS the dietary interventions remain same and if I talk about the lifestyle changes then you should be very active you should start exercise has been shown to improve pregnancy rates in women other than that you should eat you should eat foods rich in antioxidants like for example
yeah,
fruits
correct.
vegetables nuts seeds because what antioxidants does is ki wo inflammation ko reduce karne mein help karte hain so that also increases the chances of fertility then you should also get your iron levels checked ki aapki if you're iron deficient then you should you know also incorporate some iron supplements as you know suggested by your doctor uske alawa it's very important that you reduce the amount of carbohydrates like all the dietary interventions I've talked about in the last life other than that stress management I think stress management is very important as it also affects fertility so Dr. Akti will you like to elaborate on this thing like how stress affects fertility in women
yeah because you know one thing is that when there is stress so there are certain hormones like cortisol in the body that is increased which is produced
yes, right.
Right that stress everybody hormone. Knows it's a stress hormone in common language so when it is increased it has a tendency to inhibit certain you know reproductive hormones in the brain so when it happens so there is a level which lowers the normal healthy you know estrogens in the body for a female and same is so for a male in that it will lower the male hormone that is testosterone so the increase in cortisol will inhibit the normal reproductive hormones for a male and a female so here since we are talking about PCOS so it affects the females plus also stress causes these negative you know imbalance negative inflammatory
right.
balance like I told you whether it is the ovary or whether it is the environment of the uterus that is the you know the lining of the uterus so it has a negative influence there and it lowers the chances of getting pregnant plus it lowers the chances of implantation and also increases the chances of having miscarriage so mm-hmm. as you told that incorporating antioxidant in your diet plus like people take supplements so it's better we take good amount of antioxidants, which help in fighting this, you know, stress, which is causing to release of an odd number of, you know, harmful free radicals in the body.
Right. So it's very important ki exercise or diet ke saath, like a woman should also manage their stress levels. It also plays a major role. Right.
Yeah, for that, they can also look forward to yoga and meditation.
Meditation and all the ways. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
And also, Dr. Akti, what if any women, even after making the lifestyle changes, you know, are still having fertility issues? What is the next step?
So, if suppose that happens, she's not getting pregnant or she's having fertility issues even after that, then definitely her gynec will advise her or her infertility specialist will advise her accordingly whether, you know, go for medicines to form the egg and, you know, to have a normal ovulation and then try with the husband, or she will go for the next step, that is, you know, sometimes injections are given to the patient, so that which has the same purpose of you know, increasing the, you know, formation of a good quality egg. Those things are similar, but it goes step by step. Like first we try tablets, we start with injections, and then there is, if it is still not happening, we try the other treatments, which are the assisted reproductive techniques, which are the higher end. Like we go for IUI or we can go for IVF. So that is something which is the third option with us.
Okay.
So in that also, what advantage is that the success rates are more, and also the advantage that we actually see the egg in the, you know, lab, and we know whether the quality is good or not. So it's, the other two are just, you know, we are seeing in the ultrasound that it is growing. We cannot predict how the quality is. So if we are thinking that even after this also it is not happening, then we switch to a higher method and see how the quality is. We should take the best quality egg. And then we should proceed with that, so that the chances of, you know, getting pregnant, implantation also increase, and there is less rate of miscarriage. So that is how we proceed, in short. Okay.
All right. So that was very informative. I really hope that it helped our audience. Okay, so I have a question, Dr. Akriti. When should a lady go for an IVF treatment? Like, when is the right time?
See, IVF is something which is, you know, people still are very fearful of. They think that it is so costly and, you know, we don't know whether it will be successful or not, whether we should put our, put our money into it, or whether it is so effective. But the thing is, when a lady needs IVF, the doctor will definitely tell you. And there are certain areas when she would actually require it. Like I told you, if she is not responding to oral tablets, or if she is not responding to your injections, and still, you know, or if she's trying and then the pregnancy is not happening. So, and the number of years of her getting married or her trying pregnancy is a lot, then also it becomes an indication. Plus, if there are some additional factors associated with PCOS, not just PCOS, could be her age, could be her husband having some issues.
Right. And
so then we need to just not think of PCOS. We need to have other perspective as well. And we have to see both the things and go ahead with the best option. In that some conditions, then IVF could be the best option. And definitely in PCOS also, we see it as the third option, where the first two options have been, you know, they have been tried and there has been no response, or there has been failures. And then you think of seeing the quality and going ahead with the best quality eggs. That things also we go ahead with PCO, you know, IVF.
Okay, Dr. Akriti. Thank you so much.